Hi, I'm Ryan. I'm the landscape designer here at Canoopers. Today we're going to talk about the 6 varieties of hydrangeas that are commonly grown in the Chicagoland area. Here we have panicle hydrangeas. They can be easily identified by the large cone-shaped flowers, often coming in white, and they will turn to some shade of pink as the season goes on. There are many different varieties. Here we have limelight, can get quite large. There are smaller varieties that'll stay smaller. They're gonna bloom on new wood every year, so what that means is that you can trim them in late winter, early spring, and you'll always have a reliable set of blooms every year. This variety of hydrangea can be grown in more full sun situations and is much more tolerant to hot afternoon sun. Panicle hydrangeas, like the one behind me, are really the only type of hydrangea that can be trained into a tree form, which can be used really usefully in the landscape as a nice focal specimen in the garden. You would treat these the same as you would with any other panicle hydrangea. Basically what the grower has done, or even some home growers, will basically train a shrub to be on a single stem and then it'll bush out from there. They will have the same care and flowering as any other panicle hydrangea. Here we have smooth hydrangeas. They can be very easily identified by their large white blooms that will go from either white to lime green to even a pink near the end of the season. Many of you may be familiar with Annabelle's, the most popular in this category, though there are varieties that will have a pink flower through the season. These hydrangeas can be grown in a wide variety of conditions, from shadier situations to more sun situations. They will do fine. They bloom on new wood, which means that you can prune them in late winter, early spring, and you'll always have a reliable set of blooms every season. Here we have big leaf hydrangeas. The best sun location for these guys is actually more morning sun. They prefer about 4 to 6 hours of morning sun and more shade in the afternoon to prevent from frying out. This variety can change the color from pink to blue depending on soil acidity. They will tend to bloom more from mid-June, really through August, as they are a reblooming variety. That tends to bloom on new wood, but a little bit more on old, which means that if you are to prune them, that you should do it after they're done flowering, and not in spring and not in fall, though pruning is not required by any means. There are many different categories known for this variety, most notably the Endless Summer Collection, the Let's Dance series, and the City Line series, all of which have varying sizes and very different flower types. Here we have mountain hydrangeas, very similar to big leaves in that you can change their flower color based on pH from pink to blue. The big difference is that these varieties have a better bud hardiness over the winter, so you'll get much more reliable blooming. They do tend to bloom more on old wood than new wood, even the reblooming varieties, so it is important to note that for pruning times, best to do it if you are to do it after they're done blooming in the summer and not in early spring and not in fall, as you may trim off some of your buds. Here we have oak leaf hydrangeas, very similar to panicle hydrangeas in that their flowers will be in a cone shape, they will bloom out white and then turn to various shades of pink and even red as the season continues. What differentiates these hydrangeas from many others is the shape of their leaf, similar to an oak leaf, which is how they got their name. Boast a fantacular fall color of various shades of burgundy and have a papery bark similar to a birch, which can be seen in the winter. These varieties will bloom on new wood, which means if you do prune them, the best time is to do it right after they're done flowering, not in the spring or not in the fall. Many people often ask me, when should I prune my hydrangeas? And that is a very good question. Any hydrangea variety that we carry, pruning is not required by any means, though certainly pruning can help shape a plant and help tidy it up as the season goes on. Pruning times can vary depending on what type of hydrangea you have, and it's very dependent on what type of wood your hydrangea blooms on, whether it's old wood or new wood. Hydrangeas that bloom on new wood, you can prune in late winter, early spring, whereas hydrangeas that bloom on old wood, you're gonna wanna prune late summer, kind of after they're finished flowering. So those are gonna be your oak leaves, your big leaf, and your serrata hydrangeas. Those that bloom on new wood are gonna be your smooth hydrangeas and panicle hydrangeas. When picking a hydrangea, it's very important to consider many different factors, including sun, how big you want your hydrangea to get, and what type of flower you like. Hydrangeas have many different locations they can be sited in, and some are very versatile for difficult situations. With all hydrangeas, I highly recommend planting them with compost, a good starter fertilizer. We usually recommend Biotone by Espoma, and then annual fertilizations either with Hollytone, which is another Espoma product, or our own Canooper Incredibloom fertilizer. The times to do these annual fertilizings would be in May and then every 6 weeks through the growing season. Hydrangeas will also like water. They are not necessarily the most drought-resistant plants. Some have more drought-resistant characteristics than others, namely the panicles and the smooth, though they will never really want to completely dry out. So a good 2 to 3 inch mulch layer around the base will help seal in some of that moisture, as well as supplemental watering through the hot summer months. When you are pruning these varieties, you don't necessarily want to take them all the way to the ground, as some people do. I usually recommend trimming them to about 12 to 18 inches. Leaving these old stems will help support the new growth so they don't flop over as much as you may have seen in the landscape. If you do have any questions, always feel free to call us here at Canoopers or stop in and we'd be glad to help you out.